On the 3rd of October, TV Tokyo releases a 1-minute preview of the Bleach episode. So, let's show that off, shall we? For one of its TV specials, TV Tokyo gave us a Bleach Memorial Edition, kind of commemorative look back on the series, and had a bunch of people, to be honest, couldn't really understand them, but they seemed to be talking about what characters that they liked and what they liked in the series, X, Y, and Z. However, throughout this TV program, they did release a 1-minute teaser at the start of how the episode is going to be opening, I'm going to assume. To which is probably one of the best openings to an episode that I didn't quite expect, because again, you have to remember that this series has been off air for like 10 years. So to really come in has to really make a bit of an impact, right? Who is the enemy? Why is this a big deal? Why is all these hollows disappearing? And we get this amazing monologue talking about the, you know, what we saw in the PV, you know, the 90 days, the 9 days, the nine months, etc., etc., of the rebirth of Yuha Bar. And it's brought in with this beautiful little CG like effects from the effects team, and it goes into the Quincy pendulum that then Yuha grabs and then smiles with a nice little And it really displays already who our main villain is. Then it goes straight into some really cool, what we see in the first ever chapter of the Thousand Year Blood War arc, where the alerts are going off and you see the world map of Japan, of where all the hollows are disappearing, and you see Mayuri and Akon come down on the elevator going into the control room, as you would expect. Now, the thing is, even though there's not really much that's shown visually in some sort of respects of animation, the way that it's storyboarded is really telling, because it's not really so much the characters that really inspired me, so to say. It was more so the direction and also the background and art design. Because while we had already really seen these images of Yuha's hand and hearing his voice and seeing that smile that Taguchi keeps for some reason thrown down our throats because he loves that scene so much. I mean, it is clean. What I truly love the most is the elevator shot, where each time that the elevator goes past like this red type of lighting, it's always different. Like, we're going down levels, it feels realistic. And again, it's Akon and Mayuri talking. You're not going to expect some mad animation. It is just dialogue setting us in towards where they're going. And then when we actually get to the last floor of where Mayuri and Akon are going, you are brought in with this red, like, kind of side views, right? And then you got this blue massive screen of like the world, as I said. Now, what's interesting is you have two different color palettes here, which really bring out your eyes and perspective. What's really important here is how they've used the red on the sides, where all the machines, all the computers are going haywire, where all the alerts are popping off, is that your eyes, your focus has been brought towards not the center stage, the characters in the center of where they're walking to, but you're also taking an appreciation for everything that's going on around that room in general. So you're appreciating that you are in fact in that environment. You know, you're not just tunnel visioned. It's like you're experiencing it from like a 360 degree angle. So you're appreciating all these side characters, all these little things that are going on in the background. And then you get then drawn to the blue, the calmer blue, going into seeing the map of Japan. And while you may be more focused on seeing Mayuri, so to say, or Akon or the other Sorry per number 2022, you're actually seeing that things are interactive in the background. So you're still seeing that, even though it's far away, you're seeing this map of Japan where the hollow dots are still disappearing. So these things are happening in real time, and not only when it's the close-up shot towards the end, right? Because I took notice in that. Would they be lazy and kind of cut corners? It doesn't seem that's the case. It seems that they are focusing on attention to detail, especially within the background. And I feel like that was the main focus of this shot in particular, was the background rather than the characters. So I really loved everything about this when it came to Akon shot, Sorry for 2022, and Mayuri. The one thing I was kind of questioning a little bit with this is that Mayuri, when walking towards the camera, was CGI. And I had to ponder whether it was CGI or just lighting trickery. And the reason why I say this is because people use this excuse when we first saw the pre-animated trailer, was the lighting on Ichigo's foot made it give a 3D CGI type effect, when no, it was just literally the color palette and how it was like drawn or composited, right? It was all 2D, it was just different colors. And I was wondering if this was the same effect with Mayuri, which it seems to me that it is CGI for Mayuri moving towards the camera. And I do wonder why that they did that, but again, I'll probably notice it more in a more HD version. So yeah, I am sorry that I did give you a bit of a low quality version, but that's all I could get, unfortunately. But again, you can still tell it's CG. How good that CG is in HD, I don't know, but from the quality that we see, it's not that bad. And the reason why it's not that bad is because the lighting that Taguchi uses kind of masks it really well. You can only really tell it in the captain's cloak, because other than the actual body itself and the head, you don't really notice it. Again, going from the low quality that I've given you, you only notice it in the captain's robe. And to be fair, it doesn't look that bad. I'm actually genuinely surprised. I mean, I am still concerned if they're going to use CG for other characters at really random moments, of course. But again, I'm interested to see. But then again, it doesn't seem like I'm that opposed to it at the moment. So hopefully I keep getting proven wrong to a point of which I'm confident to be like, do you know what? Go for it, man. Like, just keep going with what direction you're ever going for. Because even after that cut, you go back to seeing Mayuri walk forward from behind, and it's all drawn anyway, and it looks good. So everything, again, I know it's a bit of a meme, everything's on model, everything is fluid from what we see in terms of movement. And to be fair, for a shot and a scene with Yuha and Mayuri, these aren't scenes that are expected to have high animation. You know, it is very simple, it is very concrete, and it did its job of what it needed to do. And I think the most important thing in this scene wasn't how fluid Mayuri's eye twitches were, or how, you know, fluid his mouth flaps were, but more so the environment that we were in. And that was the shot that Taguchi wanted, and the colouring and the artisticness of that is where it hit home the most. So what do you guys think of this key visual? If you want to see it in its full, there's obviously, it's in my Twitter account. I'll put the link in the description below, because I don't want to get copyrighted up the wazoo. So, you know, with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.